Hi, this is Simon, and this is a very short video just talking you through this patch. As you can see, there's actually not much to this, but let's make sure we understand everything that's happening. Up top here, I am getting the keys from the keyboard, and I'm selecting for key number 32, which is the space bar. In performance, the way that I'm creating that space bar is with a Makey Makey, which is a device that lets you turn various touch senses into keypads very easily. But what happens when that space bar is pressed, or if I simulate the space bar with a Makey Makey, I set a random number here between 0 and 97 with my random 98, and then I add 30 to that just to get a range 30 to 127. The reason I chose this range of numbers, again, these are MIDI numbers that I'm going for, but also I did some trial and error to sort of find some good numbers. So I can just push the space bar here, and as I push the space bar, you can see on my vertical slider, this is just showing the numbers that it's coming out from 30 to 127. Once I have these numbers, I convert them from MIDI into frequency, because what I'm running down here, these phasers are looking for some frequencies. So, for example, as I move this, you can see that my frequency goes lower there and gets higher there. Just for fun, you can see, I'm going to work backwards for a second, you see on my DAC here, I have a left and a right output. So I have the frequency set slightly differently for the right, and that's just to give a little bit of a stereo profile to my sound. Now, what's happening here is I'm using sample and hold to distort my sound. Sample and hold is one of my favorite glitchy effects. Essentially, we're doing down sampling. So you start with your sampling rate of 44,100 or 48,000, and then we can slow that down and create distortions and additional frequencies through that. So as this number changes, again, hitting spacebar, as this number changes, I'm going to be changing my sampling rate to different lower frequencies. This will create some interesting artifacts. And then for each different frequency I'm sampling at, the artifacts will be different. The way sample and hold works is every time the signal that's coming in here drops, it takes another sample. So our phaser, remember this is a sawtooth wave, so it goes up, 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 and then it drops once every cycle, right? As it's going up, it's not gonna trigger that sample and hold, but then when it drops, it triggers it. Again, once per cycle, and then the phaser is gonna cycle at this point at 1046.5 hertz. So that'll be a significant downsampling. Another idea that I was thinking about doing for this that would work in a similar way would be a ring modulator. I could create random numbers here and then just take an oscillated signal and multiply it by my ADC, and then I could create a dynamic ring modulator. So this is not very complex, but the different aspects of this, the performing on a live musical instrument, taking advantage of the Makey Makey touch sensor, gives this etude a kind of magical feel. The technology is serving the musical and expressive goals, and the piece is unified around the sound and object of the singing bowl.